Yes, good morning again. Are you able to see my slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So in the last couple of classes, we started off with module 3, that is SQL. So we discussed a basic introduction of SQL, and then we went on to see how some of the basic commands of SQL, like create, and then alter, drop, all this we saw. We also saw, more importantly, some of the constraints that you can apply to the attributes, constraints that you can apply to the table. This is what we have seen in the last class. So constraints to attributes means we can apply check constraint. We saw how we can apply not null constraint. We saw what is unique constraint. Right, these are all constraints that you can apply for any particular attribute, and we also saw some attributes which can be applied on the basically applies to the whole table, right? Like you have key constraint, then foreign key constraint. So these are all applies to the whole table as such. So when you say primary key, unique and not null applies, gets applied automatically. But apart from that, apart from the primary key, you want to make some other attribute also as unique and not null, right? So in that case, you can give separately, explicitly, you can specify while declaring that particular attribute, you can declare not null, you can declare unique, and make it behave like a primary key also, which we call as alternate keys, right? This is also possible, and we have seen some examples in the last class. Then we saw in case of foreign key, what violations can happen when you try to update and when you try to delete. So we saw there are three keywords which can be mainly used when you are trying to deal with foreign key constraints. That is cascade, we had set default, set null. These are the three important keywords that you can use when you are trying to deal with foreign key. Again, these three keywords, that is your set default, set null, and cascade, cannot be used just like that. You should always use it while you delete and while you update. On delete, on update. During these options, you have to use it along with those keywords only. On delete cascade, on delete set null, on delete set default. Similarly, on update set null, on update set default, on update cascade, you can use like that. Then we also saw what do we mean by constraint names, right? Every constraint, check constraint, can be given a name. Not null constraint can be given a name. So every constraint can be given a name, but on the other hand, giving name to a constraint is optional, okay? Then what is the use of giving this constraint name? We can drop it whenever we want. So it is easy for us. Suppose we took the example of a state where we gave a constraint like check, where it should accept only Karnataka and Kerala. So suppose after some time I don't want to do that. I want to drop that constraint. I want to start accepting all the states. Then I can say drop constraint, that particular constraint name. That's the only benefit of using a constraint name. So otherwise it is optional to use it. Then we saw alter command, why we use alter command. Then we discussed the drop command also, how we can drop schema, we can drop the table. Again, there you have cascade and restrict option, right? So that we saw difference between drop and truncate. As I told, truncate will remove all your records, but the structure of the table will be retained. Whereas drop table, it will drop everything. That means everything will get deleted. Right. I think more or less that is where we stopped. Today, let us try to write some simple queries. I want you all to write it. I'm not going to write it for you. This is the what you're seeing on my screen is the schema of the company database, which we have discussed many a times. But still, we will take some. We'll try to write some queries based on this schema. Okay, right. I want you all to note down the query and start writing it, and then share it on the screen as well. Share it on the chat box also. All right. Okay, Look here, query first one. Retrieve the birth date and address of the employee whose name is John B. Smith. Right? So you will have to write this query now in SQL. Write a query for this and then put it on the chat box. I want all of you to do this. Note down this query so that I can put back the schema diagram on the screen so that you know which where which attribute we are referring and which table you have to access. That has to be noted. Write down the query and write down this question and then write the query in SQL. Retrieve the birth date and address of the employee whose name is John B. Smith. Okay, this is your schema diagram for referring to that and writing your query, because you need to know which tables you have to access. So without schema diagram, it will become difficult for you to write that query. I want all of you to write it. Are you all doing it?
Yes, ma'am.
This is a query you have to write now. I'll give you all 2-3 minutes time. I have to see your answers in the chat box. All of you are trying it?
Yes, ma'am.
Retrieve the birth date and address of the employee whose name is John B. Smith. Yes, I'm not seeing anything in the chat box. Nobody has written still. Okay, it is right from employee where name is. See, you should be very careful when you're writing. That's why I put up the schema diagram. Do we have name here? Attribute is F name. Either you should write it as F name or last name, something like that. Is it not? You should not be writing. And B date means you have to, of course, a query as such is right. But then please take care of the, the variable names also. Here it is given B date means you should follow that only. You cannot write birth date, right? That's what I'm saying. Anyway, otherwise the queries are right. Yeah. Only two of them are attending the class, looks like. Okay, let us move on. Retrieve the birth. This is what I asked you all to write. What you have put on the chat box is right actually. So select B date comma address from employee. See there, where F name is John, middle initial is B, last name is Smith. Shouldn't you write like this? This is what is right, is it not? We have given the first name, we have given the middle initial, and we have given the last name also. So John Smith, John B. Smith means you have to also take it like that. Anyway, that's okay now. But please take care that when you are trying it in SQL, obviously your variable names should be the same, otherwise it will show you error. Right. So now we have written both the queries. As I told you, anything any query given to you, you should be able to write it in SQL. You should be able to write it in relational algebra also. That's why I have put up both here. Look at that. So here we have used a pi. First, what we have done? We have said we have retrieved this particular employee. Select F name is John and middle initial B and L name is Smith. Out of employee, I have retrieved this fellow, right? So when I give this select, what is select? How it will work? How this select will work? If I execute only whatever I have marked, what will I get? If I give the query as what I have marked, what will I get as the output?
All the entities of
all. What will we get as output for what I have marked?
And all the details of
all John. The columns of John B. Smith.
All the columns of John B. Smith. All the attributes of this particular record will be displayed. Right, so you will be getting for this query what I have marked, you will be getting all this all these details you will get, the whole details, but for John B. Smith. So this will be John, this will be B, this will be Smith, SSN, whatever is the SSN, birth date, address, so on, right up to the department number, everything will be displayed. But do we want everything? No. We want only the birth date and address. That's all we want. So that is the reason out of, we have already retrieved everything at this, in this part. So we don't want everything, but so what we have done, out of whatever we have got, I am retrieving only the birth date and address. So birth date, we are applying a projection. Projection is your pi. So when you apply a projection, what will happen? It is vertical partitioning. So whatever columns I have mentioned here, whatever columns I have mentioned here, birth date and address, only that will be displayed of John B. Smith. Nothing else will be displayed. Okay, right? Select, when you use sigma, sigma is a select operation. It will do a horizontal partitioning. That means all the columns will come, but not all the rows will come. Or only those rows which are going to satisfy this condition given in select operation in sigma, only those will be displayed. So it is a horizontal partition. On this, I don't want all the attributes of John B. Smith. I want what? I want only birth date and address. So that's the reason I will apply a pi operation on that. So when I apply a pi operation, I do a vertical partitioning. So whatever columns I have specified here, only they will be displayed. The rest will not be displayed. Hence, I will get birth date and address. SQL query is pretty simple. All of you will generally do it because lab also you have some exposure, you are doing it. So you get more experience there. Whereas here you will not, you may not be trying our relational algebra, but it is very important that you should know how to write a query in both SQL as well as in relational algebra. Because in examination or in your lab exam, Viva, things like this can be asked. Theory paper also, they can ask you to write it in relational algebra. Okay, SQL is fine because it is select, what we want to display should come immediately after select. So I want to display birth date and address, so I have given select B date comma address. What is the table that we access here? It is only one table that is required. I'll take it from the employee table because everything is there in the employee table. What is the condition? F name is John, middle initial is B, and L last name is Smith. Right now, I also told you yesterday, SQL ka select is equivalent to what in relational algebra?
Pi.
Very good. So SQL of select is equivalent to this pi. See here, we have given select B date comma address. We have given here pi of B date comma address. Select of SQL is equivalent to your project of relational algebra, whereas your select of relational algebra is equivalent to what?
Sigma.
Yeah, that is equivalent to what in SQL?
Where?
Where? Very good. Select of relational algebra, that is sigma of relational algebra, is similar, is equivalent to your where clause of SQL. Whereas select of your SQL is equivalent to pi of relational algebra. You have to remember that. That select and this select is not the same. Any doubts so far? Anyone? Any questions? Yeah. So all of you have written simply John B. Smith. It's wrong. Akrut, your F name is equal to John is right, but there may be so many with F name as John. I can be also John C. John C. John. Something like that name can be there, right? So you cannot just check only F name. But otherwise, you have made a good effort of writing F name is equal to John. I appreciate that. But then you should also be including middle name and last name because it is already given there, right? Okay. All right. So let's proceed further. There, if there are no questions on this, let's move ahead. Yeah. Take this query now. Retrieve the name and address of all the employees who work for the research department. Write down this query. I will put the schema diagram slide so that it is easy for you to write the query from there. Because you should know which attribute is from which table you have to access all that. Retrieve the name and address of all the employees who work for the research department. Name and address of all the employees who work for the research department. I hope you have noted down the query.
This one.
Yeah. So let me put this particular slide. Yes. Now you can try writing that query now. Name and address of all the employees who are working in the research department. That is a query that you have to write. Write in SQL first. And for your internals, SQL query formulation will also be there. Because we are doing it in the lab, that part will also be there as to write some queries and all that will be there. Don't tell, no, we have no SQL chapter, we have started only now, so why did you give? SQL query formulation is also part of your first internals. SQL query formulation will be there for every test. Don't think it is only when we come for SQL chapter. First unit, second unit, third unit. That's a basic, no? That's an important concept in DBMS. Without query, what you will learn. Am I clear? SQL query formulation is there for internals. So given some database, I would ask you to write some queries. May be there. Questions may be there, may not be there. I am not sure. So learn to write. These kind of classes, examples, you should be very attentive. I don't see or I don't know. Nobody speaks out, so I don't know really. Name and address of all the employees. What did we say? Who are working in the, let me check once. Yeah, name and address of all employees who work for the research department. That's a query you have to write. Take your time. I'll give you 2-3 minutes time. Check the schema diagram. That's important. That's why I see when I told you John B. Smith, none of you bother to write into, look into F name, middle initial, last name. Simply you all put name is equal to John B. Smith. That's wrong. There is no name at all, no, in the employee table. Yeah. Anyway, do this correctly. If you have done, let me know. I'll move to that screen and see. Has anyone done? Okay, select F name, last name, address from employee department where D name is research and D number is equal to D number. D number, yeah, okay. All right, so okay, there it is, D number, is it? All right, Arvind, you are right. Akrut, F name, employee, D name is research. No, Akrut, you should check for the primary keys which are connecting employee and department. That is important. You have missed out on that. It is not sufficient if simply you check D name is research, because there may be two research departments, is it not? We don't never know, because D name is not a, assuming D name is not a primary key here. It is D number which is primary key. So I'll have to check that also. That way Arvind is right. Akrut, you heard me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, that's all. Nobody else? All right. Let's move to the query and see. So this is the query. Retrieve the name and address of all the employees who work for the research department. See here. This is what I told you. Select F name, L name, address from employee and department. These are the two tables you have to access. What is the condition given? D name is research, and this is very important that you have to check the primary key and the foreign key. Otherwise, things may be wrong. We D name is research. D name can be, there can be two research departments. We never know, because D name is not a primary key. So hence, we D name can accept duplicate values. Is it not? So to avoid that confusion only, we are checking this primary key and foreign key. All right, so D name research is a selection condition. It corresponds to, what did I do? Yeah. So D name is selection condition. So in the select operation in relational algebra, if you want to write this, you would write this as a D name as a research, as a sigma, right? And D number is a join condition, again corresponds to join operation in relational algebra. You have to use a join here, this kind of an operation that we used. Right, between employee and department. Right, so let's move further. If there are no questions, yeah, write this query for every project. We have written this, if you remember. I don't know if you remember our previous classes, and if you have attended it very attentively, we have written this query in relational algebra already. Now we are going to write it in SQL. For every project located in Stafford, list the project number, the controlling department number, and the department manager's last name, address, and birth date. Note down this query. I will display the schema diagram slide. Note down this query and write and put it in the chat box. We have already written this query in relational algebra using pi and select, or rather pi and sigma. We have done that, if you remember. I don't know if you remember this. We have done it in relational algebra, which is there for your internals also. Okay, have you all noted down the query? For every project which is located in Stafford, list the project number, the controlling department number, and the department manager's last name, address, and birth date. That is what you have to display. Right. Write the query now. For every project located in Stafford, list the project number. So you have to display the project number, the controlling department number, the department manager's last name, address and date. Done, anyone?
Ma'am,
yeah,
can you show the schema diagram?
Yes. Anyone finished? No one. Not able to write, is it? For every project located in Stafford, list the project number, controlling department number, and the department manager's last name, address, and birth date. Is there anyone who has written? Shall we go to the solution? Is there anybody who has done it? Okay, select number, bdate, NGR SSN is equal to SSN and P location is equal to Stafford. Select, okay, let me see what you all have written. Aravind should be okay. And Manish, P number, controlling department number. SSN, last name, address, birth date from project, department, and employee. D number, okay. None of you have checked for project number with the department number. That should be checked, no? Project number in that particular table, right? The project is controlled by a department, right? Let me go to this and show it to you. Yes. See here, select. I think most of you have done it right. Anyways, P number, last name, address. So you have to consider three different tables. D number is equal to D number. Of which table you are taking? D number of project and the number of department has to be checked. Then SSN, manager SSN of department and employee has to be checked, and P location has to be staff. Right. If you written it like this, then you are right. I think some of you all have written like that, then it's right. Let me see what you all have done. MGR, SSN, location is equal to Stafford. That's right. Manish is right. Rupak is also right. Naravind is also right. Yes. Good. Good effort. Okay. So the joint condition, this is one particular joint condition that you are using. Again, you have to check for one more condition, joint condition. And then you are retrieving. Yeah.
Ma'am, like I wrote the SSN is equal to MGR SSN. So does it matter with the order?
I didn't get you. What you're saying?
Ma'am, just like taking the example of Manish, how he wrote MGR SSN is equal to SSN. And okay. I wrote SSN is equal to MGR SSN.
Oh, that's okay. That's okay. Not an issue at all. That's not an issue.
Okay.
Yeah, good. Good. Anyways, let's. If there are no questions from anyone on this, let's move forward. Any doubts? Any queries? Any question on this? All right. Let's move further. Okay. Now, the next thing that we'll be seeing is what is called if you have ambiguous attribute names. That means if you have same attribute name in two different tables, like for example, D number, okay, I have written as dnum, not as one place dnum, one place d number, at least I'll be able to make out. But I am not doing that. Same name if I use in two tables, same attribute name. Then it will lead, it will lead to ambiguity for SQL, which attribute it has to consider. That is why we go for what is called as aliasing. Aliasing means you are trying to give some duplicate names for the table. Right? Now, before we go into that, look at this. Look at the way we have retrieved this employee comma L name. That means you are trying to qualify the attribute along with the table name. That means if there is a, let us say, not even L name, let us say there is name as an attribute. So a name will be there in employee table also, it will be there in department table also. So when I simply say name, SQL is confused as to which name it has to refer to, whether it has to refer to employee name or it has to refer to department name, right? So you can always qualify the attribute along with the table name. So I can always say employee.name, department.name. Then SQL will know which name are we referring to. Okay. So query attributes can have the same names in different tables. Only in the same table you cannot have two attributes with the same name. That is not allowed. But within the database, within one particular schema, you can have the same attribute name in different tables. That's allowed. So when that is the case, you can always qualify the attribute along with the table name. How do we do this? By we make use of a dot operator. See this department dot dname, department dot lname. So you are using a dot operator in order to access that particular attribute. Why this came again? Did I go back? Yeah. Retrieve the name and address of all employees who work for the research department. That is what we have already done this. See here, why I have shown here is employee.dnumber. Suppose this dnumber exists in both the tables, as I told you. Employee also it is there, in department also it is there. Okay. So then how do I resolve this ambiguity? So I try to qualify this D number with the table name. Employee.D number should be equal to department.D number. That's why I've taken this example. Yes. Next. Again, similarly, see here. Select F name, L name, address from employee E, department D, where dname is research and e dot d number is equal to d dot d number. So now it becomes really cumbersome for me to go on writing employee always, employee dot d number, department dot d number. So I have to type so much and it is really time consuming also if you are not really very fast in typing. then it may take some time. So to avoid that, we can always give a alias name. Alias name means what? We are trying to give some duplicate names. So I'm trying to give here employee E, department D. So that means E is an alias name for employee or a duplicate name for employee. D is an alias name or D is a duplicate name for department. So when I give this, when I declare that, when I'm trying to access the table itself, I'm using it. Look at it. I'm using it at the from clause. So the conditions when I give, I can simply give E dot D number is equal to D dot D number. Okay, so we are making use of aliases. Many of these, I think in the lab also, we have done many queries like this. Any questions still here? Any doubts on this? Anyone? All right, no doubts?
No,
yeah, tell me. Okay, fine. Next. See here, for each employee, retrieve the employee's name and the name of his or her immediate supervisor. Okay, so for every employee, I have to retrieve employee's name. I should also retrieve the name of the immediate supervisor, who is my immediate boss. So my manager's name or supervisor's name, I should retrieve. So what do I give? First, I have to display employee's name. So whatever I want to display, I have told you, we'll give it immediately after select. So I want to display first name, last name. Then look at this, S dot last name and S dot first name. That means I'm retrieving the supervisor's name. Now, here in this case, we saw, if you remember the ER diagram, supervisor was a recursive relation. That means the employee is participating in that relation twice, as a supervisor, as a supervisee. I'm being supervised, I supervise you, I'm also being supervised by somebody else, right? So the two roles I play. Now, in the same table, I'm referring the same table twice here because of that. So that is why what I'm doing, I'm giving two alias name for employee. Employee E and employee S. These two are nothing but different copies of the employee. Employees, E represents employee, look at this, in the role of supervisors, supervisees, S represents the supervisors. So what I should check, E dot super SSN is equal to S dot super SSN. Super SSN is nothing but the foreign key here in this table, right? SSN is nothing but your primary key. We have used the same key as a foreign key in this table because employee is participating in the same relationship twice. Supervisor is a relationship. If you remember that example, ER diagram. Supervisor is a relationship. What kind of a relationship it is? It is a recursive relationship. Recursive relationship means what? Same entity is participating twice. You don't have two entities as in other relationships. Employee department, employee works for department. That way, that is, works for is a relationship. Two entities you have. It's a binary relationship. But when you talk about supervisor here in this case, it is a recursive relationship. So say for the same table, we have given two alias name. Any doubts? All right, now when I use aliasing, I can also use this keyword called as. This as keyword also can be used in order to represent the alias. I can use it, I can drop it, it's optional. Okay, same query I have written here, from employee as E, employee as S. It's okay if you don't write it, it's okay if you write it also. Both are same. It can also be used, alias can also be done by using this as keyword. Here we have not used any as keyword, from employee E comma S, that's all. Two alias name for employee. Here also we have not given employee E, department D. In all our lab exercises, wherever we made use of alias name, we simply gave it. Is it not match M, stadium S, player P, place for PF, something like that. Alias name we have given. But we have never used as. It's okay if you use, it's okay if you don't use also. Am I clear? Any doubts, any questions? Right. No questions, proceed. Now, if I don't specify a where clause, what will happen? Unspecified where clause. That means I am not going to specify the where clause. Select star from employee. That's all. There is no where condition. What will happen? All the tuples of the relation are selected. Where clause, missing where clause indicates what? Indicates if you are not going to put where clause, that means there is no condition at all. There is no condition. See here, no condition. Every tuple will get displayed. Missing where clause indicates no condition. That's why I asked you yesterday, when we have select statement, can we write without the where clause? You can still write a query without the where clause. I need not put where always. Where represents a condition. I can write a query without specifying any condition. Right? See here. Retrieve the SSN values for all employees. So select SSN from employee. That's all. This will display all the SSN of all employees. Right? Here you have specified only one table, correct? You have specified only one table, employee. If I specify more than one table, then what I get is nothing but the Cartesian product. This is what yesterday somebody asked. Benaka asked me yesterday. This is what I told. He was asking whether we can display all the tables. All the records of two tables. Yes, you can. There is no joint condition. Then you can. You are just doing a Cartesian product of tuples. That's all. If there is one table, you are simply giving it as select SSN from employee. If more than one relation is specified, there is more than one table is specified in your from clause, from employee comma department, and you are not used to where condition. Where no where means what? No join condition is there. So that means you are doing a Cartesian product of the tuples. Can anyone tell me what is the difference between join and Cartesian product? Anyone? What is the difference between join and Cartesian product? What's the difference? What's the difference between join and Cartesian product?
Join is like intersection.
No. Not intersection. Yes.
Union. Join.
No. What's the difference between join and Cartesian product? Anyone? I have told you this.
I mean, join condition will be there. Cartesian.
Cartesian product means where each tuple is crossed with the real tuples in the other table.
See, I think somebody answered Manish. I don't know. So, see, in a join condition, in a join statement, there will always be a condition. In Cartesian product, there is no condition. That is all is the difference. Since there is no condition in Cartesian product, all possible combinations of tuples of both the tables will come into the Cartesian product result. Whereas since there is a condition in case of join, only wherever the condition is satisfying, only those records will come. All the records will not come in the result. Are you clear? It's a very, very important difference. One important differentiation that you should know. I've already taught you all these things. Cartesian product, there is no condition. A cross B. That is how we try to represent Cartesian product. When I say A cross B, all the attributes of A, all the attributes of B will appear in the result, M plus N. Whereas tuples, all the records of A and all the records of B, combination of these two will appear. M cross N will appear. M into N will appear there. So that means Cartesian product, since it has no condition there, every possible combination of tuples will appear. Join between two tables means you are always specifying a condition. So wherever the condition is satisfied, only those will appear. Again, followed by that, we saw what is inner join, outer join, all that we have seen. It's a very basic thing. You should have answered me, all of you. None of you, only except one or two, nobody answered. So there is no join condition, then suppose here I give select SSN from employee, comma, something else also. Some other table where SSN is there. Then it will take the Cartesian product. See here. Here also we don't have where clause. There is no condition here. Select SSN, comma, dname from employee, comma, department. What will happen? It will take the Cartesian product. Cartesian product is always represented by star x. I mean this x, small x, whatever. So employee cross your department. This is what will happen in case of this query. Because you have not given where clause. The moment you specify where clause, it becomes a join. So only where condition, where clause, when will you specify? You specify where clause whenever you want to specify some condition. Once you specify where clause, once you specify that condition, only those tuples which are satisfied, only those SSN and dname will appear. Not all will appear. But here in this query, select SSN, comma, dname from employee, comma, department. That's all. There is no where. No where means no condition, no join. So every possible combination will come. Am I clear? Any doubts, any questions at this point of time?
No, ma'am.
So you should know the difference, otherwise it's difficult. Next, use of asterisk. So when do you use this star to retrieve all the values of the selected tuples? A star is used. All the attributes you want, then you should always represent it with a star. Select star from employee where D number is equal to 5. Right? So star means all the columns will come. All the rows will not come here because you have specified a condition. Only the rows where D number is equal to 5, only those rows will come. Suppose I had not given this part at all. What will come then?
Full employee table.
Very good. Full employee table will come. All records will come. All rows, all columns will come. When I say select star from employee. Moment I give a condition here, where condition I'm giving. That means still all columns will come. But all the rows will not come because you have specified a condition. Wherever, whichever employee is from department number 5, only those employees will be displayed. Right. Next we will see this select star from employee comma department where D name is research and D number is equal to D number. Again here we will not get all the records. We will get only those records which will satisfy these two conditions. But we will get all the columns. All the columns will come from these two. If I had removed this, this will again be a Cartesian product. Since I have given this where, it is a join. Any doubts, anyone? Very, very clear understanding you should have with these basic, very, very basic there. Okay, next. Tables as sets. Okay. Table, yes, SQL always uses treats a table not as a set but as a multi-set. That means duplicate tuples, what we have given you is, yeah, duplicate tuples can appear more than once and in the result of a query. So it is not going to automatically eliminate the duplicate tuples in the result. Right? So whenever you have duplicates, duplicates will also appear in your query result. What you should use if I don't want duplicates to appear? Tell me. We have already done.
No, distinct.
Very good. Distinct. Yes. When I use distinct, your duplicates will not come. But automatically, it will not eliminate the duplicates. It should not eliminate also, because whenever you are using an aggregate function, duplicate also should be counted there, is it not? If you eliminate off the duplicates, then that means your aggregate is wrong. Aggregate means what? Sum. If you take the sum by eliminating duplicates, that's wrong, is it not? So that's why automatically duplicate elimination is not there. So sum you are taking here, let's say you are taking count, you are taking average. These are all aggregate functions. So for which duplicates also matters a lot, right? So that is the reason SQL will not automatically eliminate the duplicates in the result. If you want to eliminate them, then you have to explicitly eliminate it by giving the distinct keyword. Right. So here, SQL table with the primary key is restricted to being a set, since the key value must be distinct in each tuple. See here, whatever I told you is already here. Keyword distinct. Look at the spelling, it's very important. Can be used in select clause if duplicates have to be eliminated. That's what I told you, and we have done and tried it also in the lab. We have entered some duplicate values, we try to give it distinct, and then we have eliminated. So if you want to eliminate, you can eliminate it, but SQL will not automatically eliminate them, right? Select salary from employee. Or, see here, you can also use this keyword called as all. Select all salary from employee. Both will give you duplicates. Both will give you duplicates. Simply you say select salary from employee, it is not going to eliminate your duplicates and give it. It will give along with duplicates only. But if you want to eliminate them, please use the word distinct. Select distinct salary from employee. That means I don't want to eliminate the duplicates. Set operations, yes, we have to start with set operations. Probably I think we can take it up in the next. Any doubts, any questions so far in this point? Till here, any doubts, anyone? These are all very important concepts that you should know.
No.
Yeah. You may feel it is all very simple and fine, but then see, when I asked you join and Cartesian product, not many answered. Very few, one or two are answering, that's all. Should be immediately ready with answers, and be ready to unmute and speak immediately. I don't see that at all in this class. I don't know why. So join and Cartesian product, such different, not just that, but any other difference also, you should know it, like that. It's very easy to, if when I'm teaching, you may feel it is all very simple and easy to understand, but then when I ask you, you are not able to answer, or I don't know if you don't want to answer, I am not sure about it. Okay, as I told you again, before I forget, I have told you already, formulation of queries, SQL queries, relational algebra, of course, is there in your syllabus only as for internals, but SQL queries, how to write, writing some particular query for a given example is there for your internals also. That I am not eliminating that, because we have done it in the lab also. Many queries we have been writing. Now you would have got a hang of how to write queries, right? So that's why I am not eliminating that. All the three internals, you will have it. Formulation of queries in the paper. Right. So, are there no questions for whatever we have discussed till today in the today's topic?
No.
Answer your attendance, Anaga.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Abhilash.
Yes, ma'am.
Akhil. Okay, Akrut.
Yes, ma'am.
Anusha.
Yes, ma'am.
Aravind.
Present, ma'am.
Alifullah.
Yes, ma'am.
Danaka.
Present, ma'am.
Banu.
Yes, ma'am.
Bhargav.
Yes, ma'am.
Rahmatullah is present. Chaitra.
Present, ma'am.
Chandana.
Present, ma'am.
Karan.
Yes, ma'am.
Rakshani.
Ma'am, present, ma'am. Darshan, present. Ah, yeah.
Yes, yes. Darshan.
Present, ma'am.
Diksha.
Present, ma'am.
Yeah. Kishan.
Present, ma'am.
Harshit.
Present, ma'am.
Hema. Hema is present. Huma.
Present, ma'am.
Jayant.
Present, ma'am.
Divya.
She is present, ma'am. She have put in chat box.
Kaushik.
Present, ma'am.
Lakshmi Lavanya.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Manish.
Present, ma'am.
Manoj.
Present, ma'am.
Mohit. Naval.
Present, ma'am.
Navya.
Present, ma'am.
Nikhil. Nikhil is present. Kanindra.
Present, ma'am.
Pavan.
Present, ma'am. And Mohit also present.
Pooja.
Present, ma'am.
Purnima.
Present, ma'am.
Raman.
Present, ma'am.
Rashmi.
Present, ma'am.
Rupa.
Yes, ma'am.
Sai Kumar. Present, he is. Yes, Samir.
Present, ma'am.
Santosh.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Charan.
Present, ma'am.
Shashank.
Present, ma'am.
Sheetal.
Present, ma'am.
Shivani.
Present, ma'am.
Soumya.
Present, ma'am.
Spurti.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Gardini.
Present, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Sushmita.
Present, ma'am.
Sushmita, you?
Present, ma'am.
Tirtha.
Present, ma'am.
Tirti.
Present, ma'am.
Ashavina.
Present, ma'am.
Present. All right. Rantula is present. Divya is present. Then Hema is present. Nikhil is present. Sai Kumar and Mohit are also present. I don't think anyone else is absent here today. Then let me check. Yeah, all of you seem to be present. Yes. So tomorrow's lab class, I think some of you had some doubts on second exercise and all that. So maybe the first half an hour to 45 minutes, let us spend on discussing any of the queries so far that we have discussed, not just what I think Mohit has asked for some doubts in the second exercise, not just second, since maybe some of you also have and you have not asked, I don't know. First exercise, second exercise and third exercise. All the three exercises, whatever queries we have done so far, if you have any doubts, we'll first spend half an hour to 45 minutes clarifying only those doubts. If you want some queries to be redone, I will redo it. But you'll have to come prepared as to what you want me to redo. Okay, whatever is here. So first half an hour to 45 minutes, let's have a doubt clarification class. And then we'll begin with what we are supposed to do for tomorrow. Is that clear? Should that be okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
So go through all your queries, wherever you have it, not necessarily queries, creation, insertion, wherever you have any doubts with respect to the first three exercises that we have completed so far, right? Because immediately after your theory internals, we may also have to start off with our first lab internals, okay, mind you. So keep that also in mind. So keeping that in mind only, I'm telling this. So tomorrow, first half an hour to 45 minutes, we'll have a doubt clarification class, and then we will take up our next exercise, what we have to do. Okay. Right then. So tomorrow we'll meet in the afternoon. Thank you, students. Thank you all.